Hello friends, welcome to session 2 on presentation on eOffice, which is giving you the overview on the eOffice and its important features. And we have covered in the last session the following items. What you are seeing on the screen, we have discussed that what are the various modules available in the version that we are going to implement over Indian Railways, and then various modules in detail that we have seen, and then what are the unique features that has been built into the eOffice that is going to be offered to the Indian Railways by the RailTel Corporation of India Limited. And we have seen that how it is accessible from various platforms, and then how it is compatible to various modes of the mobile devices, and then how your eOffice platform has been secured by a three-tier security system, like your NIC email IDs, OTP, and then the DSCs. We also have seen the overview of that eOffice is already present over Government of India, many departments, many state governments. And we have started the discussion on the requirements to be fulfilled for the railways for the successful rollout of the eOffice. We have discussed in detail in the video 1 of the introduction to the eOffice, the basic user data form, how it is to be filled, what are the various columns available in it, what is the significance of the each column. So I request that railway divisional in charges or the zonal in charges, whoever is there on behalf of the railways nominated, please make these forms available to the RailTel Corporation so that we will process your NIC email IDs and we will procure the DSCs. We will make available these templates of the basic user database and then employee master database, and then one more thing is there, that file naming system we will make available as an attachment to this video. You please go to the description section and then you can download the Excel sheets attached with that. Now let us discuss the second template, that information to be gathered by the railways regarding all the eOffice users, so that is the employee master database template. This employee master database template is at the heart of the eOffice platform, right? So this is where that it is defined, that where the employee is working, which organizational unit he belongs to, and then who is his reporting officer, and then his reporting officer belongs to which organization unit. All those things are going to be discussed in this, mapped in this employee master database template. So you see here that there are the various columns are there, and then all these columns are mandatory to make this employee functional on the eOffice platform. So let us go one by one why this template is required, right? So the employee designations, the employee, once the email ID, NIC email ID is created, this employee needs to be created on the eOffice platform. So we need to create the organizational units, and then within that organizational unit we need to fit the employees. That is the exercise will be carried out using this employee master database template. So you will see here, I will discuss the column by column, that how this template needs to be filled by you, so that we can feed this data into the system by the concerned railway administrator and then make the eOffice functional for your division or the zonal headquarters or the production unit. And then workflow is, the one more thing is that here when we say wherever that the who is the in charge officer or reporting officer to an employee, then it should be strictly on the administrative control basis, right? For example, one deputy senior DST is there, he will be having the administrative control, head will be the DRM, whereas the technical control head will be the PCST. So in the eOffice platform, whenever you are defining that who is the reporting officer, you should strictly mention whoever is there on the administrative control for your day-to-day working. And then eOffice, so we'll see that each column, that how it is to be filled in, right? So the column number 1 and 2, as you are seeing that just it is a title, column number 1, 2. So you fill it like that, and then employee full name you give it, surname followed by the given name, so that the name will become unique. If you just to mention that Ramesh Babu T, then there may be a 2-3 people may be there. Similarly, some you say that some Sushil Kumar, then there may be more than one Sushil Kumar exist. I request you that to kindly elaborate your name, giving the surname followed by the full name, the given name, so that your name becomes unique on the eOffice platform. And then you fill that the next column, the gender, and then you fill this IPass number. This IPass number is well known nowadays. That is your PF number preceded by the 3-digit railway code of your parent zone. And then that will be available on your payslip. Kindly see that it is 11-digit number. So that number needs to be furnished here. And then column number 5 and 6. So column number 5 is about the group of the employee. You need to mention that whether he belongs to the group A or B or C or D. Accordingly, you fill that column. And then the designation of the employee. This designation of the employee that you need to give it that, for example, some person is working as a senior DVM in one division, let us say that Hyderabad division. So if you say that what is the designation, there are the three columns are there which is closely resembles to each other. Those are your designation and then your post name of the employee. And then one more column will be there, that is the marking abbreviation. So these are the three things which will be a little resembling to each other and then may lead to a little confusion. I will spend little more time on these things. You see here, one is there the designation of the employee, and then one more is there the post name of the employee, and then one more is there marking abbreviation of the employee. So these three resembles to each other, but there is only a slight modifications are there. Let us see that what it is. Let us say that in the serial number 1, the title and then the employee name is the Ankur Mittal, and then his IPass number was given. You fill the service group to which he belongs to, let us say that group A, and then designation is given as a senior DVM. This designation is the bare designation which is not having any other attachments. So either the senior DVM or the chief OS or the SSE or the JE. So only these things are given in this designations column. This is a broader category to which the employee belongs to. The next one is the post name of the employee. The post name of the employee is an elaborative thing. That means the more detailed description of the job or the post he is holding. Let us say that one SSE is there for him, SSE signal headquarters, one person is there. For him, the designation used to be filled as the SSE, just SSE, right? So remaining things will become the further attributes that comes in this post name column. So the designation should be strictly the broader category, and then the post name will become SSE signal headquarters. Similarly, for senior DVM, his designation is the senior DVM, whereas his post name is the more elaborate version of that is the senior DVM operations Hyderabad South Central Railway. So like that, you need to make the designation column as well as the post name of the employee clearly distinct. This is a broader category. This is a specific to that post. And then what you are seeing here, the marking abbreviation, that is nothing but your post name of the employee plus some three letters from the name of the employee. So why this is required is that whenever you are trying to send some file to someone, you can search that person by his designation or by his name. When you are searching by designation, let us say that senior DVM you are searching, there may be a lot many senior DVMs are available on the eOffice platform across the Indian Railways. You should not by mistakenly sending to someone. So that if the to whom you want to send, if you know the person by name, then you will be able to see that, okay, I want to send to this person. So this is the identifying the person uniquely to whom you are sending the file or any correspondence on the eOffice platform. So I think I am clear on this, that one is the designation, this is a broader category to which the employee belongs to, and then the post name of the employee is a very specific thing, and then marking abbreviation is particular to that employee. That means his post name plus three letters from his name. In this case, Mr. Ankur Mittal, for him it has been appended with AKM. So any three letters you choose, and then you make it append here. So with that, these three columns information needs to be filled. In the similar fashion, you need to mention that who is the name of the reporting officer. Name of the reporting officer is the post name of the reporting officer. So for example, the senior DVM Hyderabad South Central Railway, he is reporting to the DRM Hyderabad South Central Railway. So the post name of the reporting officer should come full. Just simply mentioning the DRM will be misleading you need to give specific full attributes of the post of the reporting officer. Now we will come back to the next important item, that is called the organizational unit and then further things. So right now how we are functioning in the department wise and then office wise, in the similar fashion on the eOffice platform, every employee will be either heading the organizational unit or he belongs to an organizational unit. Let us say that there is one senior DOM office available in Hyderabad division. So you will find that to which office he belongs to, the senior DOM belongs to the office of the senior DOM Hyderabad. And then all the employees who is working under him also belongs to the office of the senior DOM. So that will become the organizational unit. That means to which office you have belong to. So this is the broader category. Similarly, the DRM belongs to the office of the DRM. And then his PA or the PS, whoever is there, they also belong to the office of the DRM. That means every employee on the eOffice platform either belong to one or the other organizational units, which is exactly similar to right now, every one of us must have been fitted into one or the other bill units we belongs to. There are no employee available over the Indian Railways who doesn't belong to one or the other bill units, otherwise his payment is not getting drawn. So similarly on the eOffice platform, every employee must be belonging to one or the other organizational. Similarly, every employee must belong to one or the other organizational units. So let us see that how the organizational unit is fitted in this detailed template. Let us take that the serial number one, who is the Mr. Ankur Mittal, who is the senior DOM. His post name is senior DOM O Operations Hyderabad Southern Railway, and then his marking abbreviations is his post name plus three letters from his name. And then the post name of the reporting officer is the DRM Hyderabad Southern Railway. And then comes here to which organizational unit this employee of the serial number one belongs to. So senior DOM belongs to office of the senior DOM. That should be clear to you. So this is what is to be filled here. It is the office of the senior DOM operations Hyderabad Southern Railway. That is the name of the organizational unit to which he belongs to, and then that one he is heading also. And then comes to the next one, the parent OU. So we'll complete this category first, then we'll go to the parent OU. So the senior DOM belongs to the organizational unit of the senior DOM O Hyderabad South Central Railway, and he is also the head of this organizational unit. Let us say that there is one senior PA who is attached to the senior DOM. There is one TI attached to the senior DOM. So let us say that this senior PA attached to the senior DOM, Mr. M. Nagesh, right? So his full designation, his designation is senior PA, whereas his post name is senior PA / senior DOM O / Hyderabad / SCR. That is his post name. And then his marking abbreviations will become his post name plus three letters from his name, Mr. Nagesh, NAG, MNH. Now comes to the post name of the reporting officer. The senior PA of the senior DOM reports to senior DOM O Hyderabad Southern Railway. So this is clear. Now comes here to which organizational unit this senior PA of the senior DOM belongs to. So he belongs to office of the senior DOM only. So this is the thing, it should be clear to you that senior DOM belongs to the office of senior DOM, and then his senior PA also belongs to the office of the senior DOM. His TI also belongs to the office of the senior DOM. This is how these organizational units should be filled in this template. When you come to further, there is one DOM working under the senior DOM. So again the same thing. So you fill these details. Post name is the DOM. His designation is the DOM. His post name is DOM G Hyderabad Southern Railway. Right? It is very clear. And then marking abbreviations. His post name plus three letters. It has been given here. And then the post name of the reporting officer. The DOM G is reporting to senior DOM O. So the post name of the reporting officer is the senior DOM O headquarters. And then comes here to which organizational unit this DOMG belongs to. So here that NIC adopts that a standard convention that every officer and then every sectional in charge supervisors will have their own office. So according to that, this DOMG will have the office of the DOMG. Similarly, every officer will have their own office, and then you should clearly mention them. They belong to office of the ASTE Construction Hyderabad, Senior DOM Construct DOM G, and then Hyderabad. So like that, every officer you put it as office of so and so. Similarly, some sectional supervisor is there who is heading a group of the people in the wayside stations. For them also, we are all with the same convention we are having right now also. That is the office of the SSC PBA someplace. Similarly, on the eOffice platform also, you need to create the office of so and so. This is how that this organizational structures needs to be filled. And then I request you that while filling the organizational structures, you please follow from the top down approach. You start with the DRM and then you go to the ADRM, then come down to the branch officers, then you keep on filling those things. So in that way, it becomes very easy for you. Then the same approach should be made in the zonal headquarters departments. Once you complete this one, then you come to the parent OU, right? So how the senior DOM belong to office of the DOMG, similarly, his reporting officer DRM belongs to office of the DRM Hyderabad Southern Railway. So in this fashion that you are completely mapping the employee, his details, where his post name, and then where he is working, and then who is his reporting officer, and then his reporting officer belong to which office. So all those things are captured in this employee master data template. And then this is the template which we are going to feed into the system, where the employee is to be defined, and then employee needs to be created on the eOffice platform before rolling out of the eOffice for your unit. Now you come to that, we'll just roll back and then just to see that so far what we have discussed. We have gone through the template, serial number one. The column number one is the serial number, and then column number, this thing is the title. Column number two is the employee name in full, and then column number three is the gender, and then column number four is the IPAS number, up to which there is no confusion. It is clear. You please give, you keep this EMD template filled for all your employees to whom you have already given the basic user database. In your basic user database, you are having 250 employees you have given it. The same 250 employees must be found in the employee master database also. So I think there is no confusion concerned to the column numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. Now come to the column number 6. Column number 6 is the broad designation of the employee, that is the senior DOM or SSE or the chief OS or TI. So like that, there is a broader category of the employee's role or the designation, strictly speaking. And then come to the post name. The post name is the further narrowing down of his what the post that he is holding, that is the senior DOM is holding the post of senior DOM O Hyderabad Southern Railway. Similarly, one SSE is there, his designation is the SSE, whereas his post name is SSE Signal VKB SCR. That is the complete description about his the post he is holding right now. And then this marking abbreviation is nothing but the post name of the employee appended with three letters from his name. Then comes to the similar to that post name, how the post name of the employee is there. Similarly, the post name of his reporting officer also will be there. Senior DOM O Hyderabad Southern Railway, and then his reporting officer is the DRM Hyderabad Southern Railway. SSE Signal Vikarabad is the post name of the employee. The reporting officer's post name is the DST1 Hyderabad Southern Railway. So up to here, I think it is very clear. The designation, the post name, marking abbreviations. Similar to the post name in the column number 7, the post name of the reporting officer is also available. And then we have discussed here that the name of the organizational unit to which the employee belongs to. The name of the organizational unit to which the employee belongs to, which is similar to our pay unit bill section, right? So every employee in the pay slip, we know that we belong to the bill unit code will be there. So it tells that this employee belongs to this bill unit code. Accordingly, our salaries are drawn and then our accounts are maintained. Similarly, on the eOffice platform, all the employees are organized in the organizational unit's name. So every employee of the 250 employees, as we discussed in your list in the BUD, whoever is there, all the 250 employees should be found in this EMD template. And then all the 250 employees must be either heading the organizational unit or he must be belonging to one of the organizational unit. You see here that senior DOM is there. He belongs to the office of the senior DOM. Not only that, he belongs to the office of senior DOM, he is also heading the office of the senior DOM. Similarly, that senior PA and then the TI who belongs to the senior DOM office, they are also belonging to the office of that senior DOM. Like that, every employee you are seeing in this list must be either heading the organizational unit or belonging to the organizational unit. They must be fit somewhere in this organizational unit. That means this eOffice is organized, the workflow is organized in the form of these organizational units. Exactly similar to what we have right now. We have the office of the SSE signal X place. He will be reporting to the DHTE, that is called that the office of the DHTE. And then the DHTE is reporting to the senior DHTE, that is called office of the senior DHTE. Senior DHTE is reporting to the DRM, it is called the office of the DRM. The DRM reporting to the GM, so on, like that. Exactly in the same way, you need to make it. The only difference is that on the eOffice platform, there is no depth of the resources. So you can create as many organizational units as possible so that you will have a better structure. So NIC has given the guidelines that it is better to create organizational units for every officer and then every supervisor who is working in the field or who is heading a group of the people, so that the employees can be better organized, better segregated, and then you can have a better flow of the work. So this is where that we are stopping here this session, that not in the session, in this template on the discussion on this organizational unit. So you please create the organizational units according to this, and then similar to this column number 10, you are having the column number 11 also. How the employee belonging to the one organizational unit, in the similar way his reporting officer also must be belonging to the one organizational unit. That means every organizational unit will have one parent organizational unit. Office of the senior DHTE will have the parent OU of office of the every employee belonging to the one organizational unit. Reporting officer also must be belonging to the one organizational unit. So here the column number 10 and then column number 11 are most important units of the eOffice platform. The entire eOffice, that structure has been defined in the form of the organizational units. One organizational unit will be there, it will have the one parent organizational unit. So this is the organizational unit to which this employee belongs to. This is the organizational unit to which his reporting officer belongs to. So this is how these organizational units are structured, and then that should be formulated. And then you see here that serial number 12 is the mobile number, and I repeat again that please furnish the personal mobile numbers of the employees of what you have given in the basic user database. Similarly, the date of birth columns are repeated just for the cross-checking purpose, that you are giving the same information as you have given in the basic user database. Otherwise, column number 12 and 13 are the repetition of the basic user database information that you have provided. So now moving forward, that this once the employee master database you have gathered and then kept ready with you, the next most important template you need to prepare is the file naming system template. File naming system template is the way that the NIC has designed to make the files accessible on the eOffice platform, so that you will be able to access the files in a effortless manner. So searching the e-files on the eOffice platform will be very easy, and then missing of the files or misplacing of the files will never be a case on the eOffice working. Now let us see that why this template is required to make each file as uniquely identified as possible. For example, right now we are following the manual filing system. Each division or the employees, right? So they might be following a different types of conventions, even though we have standardized it. So finding the file and then searching the file has become a tough task for us in our day-to-day working. The second one is that one can send the file to any officer over the Indian Railways, duly furnishing the reasons. So once the file has been created on the eOffice platform, the file can be marked from anyone to the any other one over the Indian Railways. For example, a DRM Guntur can send the file to DRM Northern Railway or can send a file to Railway Board directly for whatever the reasons that particular officer only can know, and then they can furnish. Whenever you are sending a file outside your defined structure, then you need to furnish the reasons why you are sending directly beyond your controlling officer or reporting officer. So, but you can send the files to anybody over the Indian Railways. Anyone create a file. Every employee, whoever is there on the eOffice platform, can create a file and then he can organize his own files. So there is no problem. For example, I am the senior DHT. I would like to keep all the circulars of the RDSO pertaining to one particular time. Then I can create myself on RDSO circulars file on the eOffice platform, and then I can keep all the correspondence what I receive electronically in that folder. So anybody can create a file, but the closing of the file can be done only by the creator. That means if I create a file, I only can close it. Similarly, that there is no such provision for deleting anything on the eOffice platform. Once you create a file, you can close the file, but you can never delete the file. Similarly, anything you create on the eOffice platform, anything you create, right? So you cannot delete. There is no such provision over the eOffice platform to delete anything. So, and then file can be closed but can never be deleted by anyone anytime. So we should need not have the fears that accidentally deleting the file or any such type of the things, right? So your files are secured on the eOffice platform. In the file naming system, you will have broadly, this is the template supplied by the NIC. So it will have the four major heads, you can say, so that the file searching will be easy. So this file naming system is basically for standardizing the naming system of the files so that the search becomes easy and then effortless. Let us say that here the file naming system, it has been selected that first, it has been organized in the form of the department. Let us say that here, that general administration is the department, right? So the files of the general administration is there. And then next category is the public grievances, and then public relations, like that. In the general administration must be dealing the broader category of the, some, let us say that some 10 issues, like the public grievances, public relations, etc. So this is the second broader category. This is the first broader category. Within that first broader category, this is the second broader category. And then the third one is that which zone are these things which belongs to. So Southern Railway, and then to which division it belongs to, the division. So that whenever the next time you are searching the file, if you press any of these attributes, let us say that Southern Railway General Administration, if I give the inputs, then it will pick up all the files belonging to the General Administration of the Southern Railway and then give it to you. If you give further specific inputs in the search, Southern Railway, Guntur Division, and then Public Relations, and then General Administration, then it will give that the specific files belonging to that particular unit. So this is the purpose of this file naming system, to standardize the naming of the files so that the search becomes easy and then universal. So an employee transferred from one place to the another place, or one division to another division, so the system of naming of the files and then searching of the files will become unique, and then everybody can be able to adopt it easily. And then there is one more column, is there, apart from these four major heads. One is the department, second one is the category, this one is the zone, and then this one is the division. The fifth one is there. This is an user defined input. At the time of creation of the file, just giving these four attributes may not be sufficient to you. Just saying that South Central Railway, Nanded Division, public grievances, and then general administration may not be sufficient to define that file. So after giving these four attributes, you can give the further attributes of the file in this user defined section. You can type here. Here it has been typed further. Passenger amenities complaint on food quality from Tirupati, something like that. So that you can create a file with full description in addition to these four attributes, so that you can retrieve the file with any of these inputs. So this is the broader category, and then this four major heads that can be decided by the railways, right, in which order they want to follow it. For example, the first broader category, if they want to define it as zone, let them make it as a zone. Next broader category, let them make it as a division. Next broader category, they can make it as a department. Next broader category, within that department, various sections. Example I will give, that the first broader category should be ideally made as South Central Railway, like all other railways. So you can select the railway, so South Central Railway. Next broader category is the division. You select the Guntur division. Next broader category can be the department. Out of the 13 departments, so you can list it, that you can select one department. Again, within that one department, let us say that engineering department, they will be having some 30-40 sections within that department. Tender section, procurement section, AMC section, zonal works, something like that. So all those things can be categorized. And then further full description of the file can be given in this area at the time of file creation. What I would like to say here is that what the railways needs to do at this stage is that to finalize this four broader categories, and then keeping the list prepared and then ready at their end. So when they have prepared and then kept that file naming system like this in this template, this template we will make available to you in the description box in the Excel sheet. Please download it from there. Otherwise you can ask your eOffice coordinator on behalf of RailTel, whoever is representing your railway, and then you please get those things from them. Once the basic user database has been supplied to the RailTel, and then employee master details you have prepared and then kept with you, and then file naming system you have prepared and then kept with you, parallelly that you please ensure that this hardware is available at each of the eOffice users. What are the hardware required? It is a very simple, right? So you see that the basic skill set is that just a browsing knowledge. Everybody is having that knowledge, just browsing the net. So if that is known, then eOffice functional, one person, one employee can do the job on the eOffice. eOffice users must need to have a basic knowledge of the computer and then internet browsing. That's it. Nothing more than that. And then the workstation, the specifications also, what is required has been mentioned as very minimum lower end specifications. I think all the computers you are having, it must be having the processor and then RAM above this. If it is not there, please initiate procurement and then augmentation to the existing workstations. And then the network, the RailTel will provide the broadband and then RailNet connectivity up to the division or up to the zonal headquarters, and then beyond that, within the division, maintaining of the LAN and then wiring and then the switches, etc., is to be maintained by the division itself or the zonal headquarters itself. So we request that you please ensure from the railway side that each user is provided with a RailNet connectivity, and then it is having a good standby paths and then robust switches and then the hardware. And then next, fourth one is the scanners. This is one item that many people are expressing concern, but in fact that right now in the manual eOffice, manual working of the file system, you must be spending hundreds of printers in the division and then procuring hundreds of cartridges and then thousands of papers and then the xeroxing and then AMCs. A lot much work must be going on, and then lot many people are deployed for this xeroxing and then distribution of the papers, collecting the acknowledgements and all. So all that things will become a redundant for you, and then you need to maintain only one asset, that is the scanners. Scanners, what is required for the eOffice functionality are the low-end scanners So it need not be the costly, and it must not be the costly as per the NIC specifications that low resolution scanners only to be used, so that you will not be overloading the servers so unnecessarily. And then one more thing is that the digitization of the existing files. Any receipt is coming, you are scanning and then you are putting into the eOffice, that is fine. But what about the existing files? Existing files, so how you will scan and then how you will be able to link it? The Railway Board has issued a minutes of the meeting and then memorandum of understanding with the RailTel. In that it has been mentioned that the digitization of the existing files needs to be undertaken by the railways. You please start the work in the digitization of the your existing files. Find a suitable agency who is having this professional experience. And then if you need any further guidance on this, right, your RailTel coordinator pertaining to your zone or division will be able to provide you the information and similar agencies that are available to undertake this job. Please engage such agencies and then start the work so that you will have a complete experience of the e-office paperless working. Otherwise, you must be doing half on the electronic transfer of the files and then half handling of the manual files. That will not give you a very pleasant experience. I request that all railways to undertake this work immediately, the digitization of the existing files. And then the software required along with the hardware is that not very advanced, right? Any Windows 7, right? And then Linux, these things will work. It will work on the Mac, iOS. So the browser side, only that Internet Explorer, Firefox has been given as they are having a better securities built on it as per the NIC. And then now they are developing a new version of the eOffice that will work virtually on every browser, including the Chrome. But as of now, I request that people should restrict themselves for the Internet Explorer 10 or above, and then Firefox ESR version 32-bit. And then about Reader 10, it is a freely downloadable version available, and then each user can download and then keep it with themselves. Then it comes to the user interface. So now we have seen that, right? So far what we have seen is that, so that eOffice, what is the eOffice, and then what are the various safety features built in it, what are the various modules covered in the eOffice, and then what are the unique features? And then we have come here, the requirements to be fulfilled by the railways. In that, the first step is the basic user data form that needs to be prepared and then supplied by the railways to the RailTel. And then we have come to this employee master database template. The formats will be made available to you. You can download from the from below this video in the description side, or you can contact your RailTel coordinator. Then keep this EMD prepared and then ready at your end, so that the moment that NIC email IDs are created, you can start feeding this EMD data into the system, and then eOffice will be rolled out for your division or the zonal headquarters. It is that simple. And then once the EMD has been filled, then file naming system, you try to organize all your existing files in a proper manner. That the file naming system is nothing but that a broader guidelines on how to standardize the naming of the files on the eOffice platform, so that while you creating your new files, you will follow the standard pattern, right? So that every file will have the first the journal name, then the division name, then the department name, then the broader category within that department, and then followed by the full description as inputted by the user. You are saying that the first broader category, next, and then this. You people can follow that convention which is suitable to you. Next, come to the hardware that should be made available to the each user we discussed. Please ensure that these things are available at your end. And then one more thing is that the antivirus you need not procure. The antivirus will be procured. Endpoint security system will be provided by the RailTel to each user. So those will be directly maintained from our servers. So you need not be worried about your the antivirus requirements for any of the users. Now we are coming to this user interface. That from here onwards, I would like to take you to the user interface of the e-file, how it looks like. Otherwise, the basic introduction of the e-office and its features has been completed. If we stop the session here, it looks like an abrupt end. So I would like to take you that further few slides, which will be explaining that how the eOffice interface and then what are the functionalities eOffice will be having, so that you will have a broader idea. Whereas the each user, right? So this comes under the user portion. That user portion, what the each user will do on the eOffice platform. So a separate training modules will be developed and then will be made available to you shortly. Otherwise, what you are seeing here, that in the user interface section, the user can do these following activities with the file. For example, any receipt is received. That means any letter has been received. Then how you will diarize that? Diarize means that you have received a letter. Let us say that from RDSO. Right, just scanning it and then putting in my hard disk will not make any use to me. So I need to diarize that. That means I need to give an input when I scanned it. After scanning, before storing that file on the eOffice platform, I need to give a further inputs. Right, this letter is received from whom, when, and then this letter is dated of what, and then who has signed that letter, and then what is the major subject of that letter, and then any minor categories are there in that letter. So that I will give all those inputs in that diarization process, and then I will save it. Then now the file is saved on the eOffice platform. Even after 10 years, if I want to retrieve it, I can retrieve that file based on any of the attributes that I have furnished there. If I remember just an RDSO, a signal related item, and then if I remember that it belongs to something around 2018, somewhere around March, December. So if I give that attributes, then it will pick up the files and then it will give it to you. Your search becomes much narrower and then you will be able to pick up the file what you want in the shortest possible time. So the diarization of the input, the receipts. So this is what the user will do. And then acknowledgement generation, right? So the moment you have sent a file to someone, that automatically that acknowledgement comes to you. You need not be delivering the things to someone physically and then getting the acknowledgement and then monitoring. So all those things will not be there. And then the receipt to receipt. For example, yesterday I have received one letter and then today another letter I have received, and then this letter is related to the yesterday's letter. I need to connect both, right? So this receipt connecting to that receipt, and then I have received today one letter and then I need to put that into a file. So the receipt can be attached to the another receipt, or a receipt can be attached to a file. I receive one letter I have received, I can put into a file, or I received one letter, I can connect it to some other letter which I have received sometime earlier. Like that, it is having a lot many features that the user will do at the receipt section. And then files, that so recording the files, what we are doing right now, the same thing will be done electronically. You can create the files. Creation of the files is easy. We have seen that in the last slide, that the file naming system, just you follow that file naming system, you select your zone or division and then department and then the broader category of that, and then give some description about that file, and then you press the button, create the file, your file is created, and then you can start putting the receipts into that. So things will get automatically stored. I would like to tell one point here, that whenever you diarize any letter or any document or anything, the eOffice will create one unique number to that receipt. And then if you remember that, the or you maintain the number of that document, you can retrieve it even by that number also. So similarly, the whatever the number is generated by the eOffice when you have diarized one document, that number will be unique, and then that number will not change later. Similarly, when you have created one file, then every file will be automatically will be allotted one number by the eOffice software, and then you can retrieve that file even by that number also. So similarly, the notings has been segregated into the yellow and then green note as per our very old convention. That means whenever you are writing something and then signing on the note, then that is a permanent, and then all those things will come on the green note side. And then whenever you are preparing some drafts, the draft is not permanent, the draft is not meant for record purpose, those drafts will be handled on the yellow note. All these things will be detailed to you in the user training module, which we will be undertaking in a short while from now. And then similarly, you will be having the user need to dispatch the things. When you have a document, for example, something has come to the let us say that it was initiated from some senior supervisor, and then it has come to the branch officer, and then finally it is approved by the DRM, and then that approved document needs to be sent to someone further. Let us say that it is sent to the zonal headquarters, it is connected on the e-office, then simply that it can be sent, dispatch can be made through the e-office itself. Or you want to dispatch it to some central government unit which is located so somewhere, and then you can send this document as a electronic attachment and then send it by mail, or you can download that and then you can hand over that as a hard copy and then dispatch it by post. So all those things will come under this dispatch section, how the dispatch needs to be handled when in connection with the eOffice platform. Similarly, the eOffice firm suit will come with you MIS section. You will generate lot many reports. So for example, that how many files are dispatched, how many files are received, how many files has been kept pending for how long time, how much time it has taken to handle the each file on an average. So all those statistics gets automatically getting generated. And then this is the process broadly, that when you have received some receipt or a letter, so what you will do? The first, the receiver will scan the inward receipt or the letter and then store it in the your desktop, and then you browse and then upload into the eOffice platform. Before uploading that, you need to give the metadata, that is called the diarization. So the diarization, this the template will come, you need to enter the data, who is the sender, from where the letter was received, when the letter was received, what is the letter number, what is the subject of that letter, and like that some information is there. So you need to fill all those information. Then the moment you enter the metadata, the system generates a sequential diary number for the e-receipt. Now that document is kept on the eOffice platform, and then it cannot be altered or it cannot be deleted from the system. Once the receipt number, diary number is received, then that becomes the part of the eOffice system. It cannot be deleted. Then whatever the receipt that you have diarized, you can send that to concerned person, right? So forward it to 10 people in the form of the receipt at a time, or you put into a file and then you send the file to the next concerned officer, or you have received one letter and then for that no existing file category it belongs to, then you create a new file and then enter the metadata for the file. How you have created a receipt metadata, similarly here also for the file metadata will be entered. Like the file metadata is nothing but your broader, four broader categories and then the description, and then you create a file and then put that receipt into that file and then send the file to the concerned person. You can send that person the next higher in authority or anyone that you want, to whom you want to send the file. You can send it by with signature or without signature, depending upon the nature of the communication that you are making. For example, you are signing some note side, then it must be signed digitally, and then DSC sign you do, and then you send to the sender, right? So next to officer. For example, you are sending just some letter for the information purpose, you can decide to send it just like that as an attachment. You need not be using the digital signature. So this is how that it is organized, the entire workflow. Whenever you have sent a file or a letter to the user, immediately you will know that when this letter or the file is dispatched to him, and you also know that whether the user has opened the file or not, whether the user has seen the letter or not. So dispatching the letter to the user inbox is different, and then the user opened that file and then seeing is different. Just like your WhatsApp marks, you get it, right? One tick, double tick, and then green double tick, like that. So you will be able to know complete this thing. This is how that, for example, if I am the employee on the eOffice platform, and then I have the office, and then I will go my office, but in the usual sense that my office on my desk, there may be certain files will be there. Once the entire system is migrated onto the eOffice platform, I will not have any files on my desk because there are no files available physically. So whatever all the files that has been marked to me will come in my file inbox. So these are the files available there, and then I will click on this and then I will open the file. I will see it is an information based file. Just I will open it and then I will close it, or if it is something that I need to be acted upon, I will act upon that, and then I will create a note sheet and then I will digitally sign it and then send to the concerned official. So this is how that, this is the document that I have received. Let me assume that in the previous this thing on this screen, right? So this is the file I have received, and then on that file, the file head will be looking like this, right? So it will have the attributes and then file cover. So these things we will discuss it in detail at a later stage when it comes to the user training and then admin training. These are the two training modules which we are going to cover later. So one is a user training that covers these items, so how the user has to handle it in the day-to-day business, what job he will do when the file comes to him, or when a receipt comes to him, what he has to do. All those things will be discussed in detail in the user training module. When it comes to the admin training module, those things that how the EMD is to be prepared, preparation guidance has been given, how the EMD is to be inputted into the system for their department or for their division, that will come under the detailed admin training program. So two further major modules will be delivered to you for the training purpose on the eOffice platform. One is the complete user training module, and then the second one is the complete admin training module, and then third one is there very minor but very most important thing, that is the complete training module for the super admins. So these are the three training modules we will be undertaking and then developing, and then will be delivered to you shortly. But I request you that you can start working on these existing things and then complete this BUD and then EMD and then FNS systems. Now, as I discussed in the last slide, that I have received a file here. You see here this file I received, and then I clicked on that, the file got opened, and then I need to provide some information back. So I have recorded my comments here, and then I have referred some portions of the file, and then made an attachments here, and then I have digitally signed and then send it to the, this is the digitally signed. When you put a DSC and then you input your username password, then wherever you keep it, the digital signature appears, and then to whomever you mark it, the file will be delivered to him, to them. This is how that workflow has been organized. So the moment I have received a file on my inbox, and then I have prepared a note, and then I have signed it. Once I sign it, to whom I need to send it, I will select it, and then how I need to send also, this comes under the dispatch section that will be covered in the user training at a later stage. So this is how that I will select the recipient, and then I will press a send. Simply, if it is an information based thing that I want to send it to, I will just press a send button. So it will be dispatched to him. In that case, you will not see a digital signature sign here. If it is something like a note that I am putting up to my controlling officer or something of that kind, then I must choose this DSC sign and send, so that the note which I am sending to my controlling officer will go with my note plus signature. So this is how the eOffice functionality has been organized. And then this is the search page, that any file you want to search, right? So you can search creation year, origin, from where it got origin, for Southern Railway, Southwestern Railway, like that. The many attributes are there. The moment you give the inputs and then you press the search button, the file will be picked up and then it will be given to you. So right now we must be spending the days and then weeks, sometimes months, and then we are not able to trace the files, and then misplacing of the files. So all such scenarios will be a history from now. Thank you very much for your patience, for listening to this training session, for going through this training session and this eOffice introduction. So I request you all that to kindly prepare your basic user database and then hand over to the Railtel Corporation Limited, and then keep the EMD prepared and then file naming system prepared, and then keep it ready with you. The moment the NIC email IDs comes to us, the movement to, and then the DSC applications also, please collect it from the your employees. The form templates will be provided to you by the RailTel coordinator pertaining to your region. So all these activities has been completed within a 1 month duration over the Guntur division or the Southern Railway. So, and then for that, what the division and then Southern Railway headquarters units and all, they had a well organized WhatsApp groups. Those groups has worked as our medium for a quicker communications, and then we are able to deliver the goods or the result, sorry, right? So I request all the divisions and then the zonal headquarters to create a separate WhatsApp groups for the e-office rollout, and then it should be headed by the head of that unit. For example, in this case, the Guntur division, the e-office group of the Guntur division was led by the DRM Guntur, and then the e-office group of the Hyderabad division is led by the DRM Hyderabad. Similarly, in Southern Railway, all the e-office groups formed by the each division was led by the respective divisional head, that is the DRMs. And in Southern Railway headquarters, WhatsApp group has been formed, and then the DGM is the coordinating officer for the e-office rollout for the entire Indian Railways. However, the AGM is the overall in charge for the e-office functionality over the zone as per the Railway Board instructions. Accordingly, the e-office WhatsApp group that has been formed in the Southern Railway is headed by the AGM. So AGM will be the monitoring and then issuing the suitable instructions to the various railway units to quicken up the things. So otherwise the things will get slowed down or some people may not respond to you. So I request that each division and then zonal headquarters to be headed by the respective head of that units, so that you will have a quicker response and then quicker information flow. The major and then the key to the success of the e-office rollout is the gathering of the information. So if the information is gathered in the form of the basic user database and then given to us, right? For us, it will take around 1 week to 10 days time to create the NIC email IDs and then give it to you. Similarly, the DSC forms that once you come across, you complete the basic user data forms, you will know that how many people needs the DSCs. Accordingly, the DSC forms you collect and then hand over to us, we will take hardly 7 working days to give you back the DSCs. And then in the meantime, if you keep your employee master data ready and then file naming system is ready, then we deliver to you the admin training module and then super admin training module, and then the nominated admins and then super admins will be able to feed the data into the system. And then I will be organizing next to one more video session on the detailed requirements to be fulfilled by the railways for the successful rollout of the e-office, and then the roles and responsibility of the railways, and then roles of the responsibility of the RailTel will be detailed in the next video session. So thank you very much. I hope that you people will act fast and then facilitate the rollout of the e-office within the stipulated time. Thank you.